Hey everyone. In our last video, we talked a bit about what Lagrange polynomials are and how we can use them to interpolate data. In this video, we are going to go through a Lagrange polynomial interpolation example so that you can see how we solve one of these problems. We are asked to estimate for the output of the following data set using Lagrange polynomials. I am just going to take a second and write out the formula for a Lagrange polynomial here. If you have seen our previous video on Lagrange polynomials, we talked about the degree of them. And as we learned, since we have three data points presented, we will have three terms in our second order Lagrange polynomial. Now, let's talk about how to solve this problem. We will first begin by using the formula above to develop our general second order Lagrange polynomial equation. Then we will plug in our known discrete data points, simplify our polynomial, and then lastly, once we have the Lagrange polynomial developed, we can plug in the input that we are asked for and finally solve for the output. As we said, our first step is to develop the general second order Lagrange polynomial equation, which I demonstrated in the past video. In brief, we know that we will need one term for each data point we have, as we need our Lagrange polynomial to pass through every data point that we give it. I will just go ahead now and rewrite the general second order Lagrange polynomial equation that we found in our last video. Now that we have that written all out, we just completed our first step in the solution. We must now plug in our data points and simplify, such that the Lagrange polynomial is fit to our specific problem. I'm just first going to solve for each individual term presented here. To further simplify, I'm just going to group our x terms and our constant terms. Which will look like this once completed. Now I'm just going to simplify the coefficient terms. As these are rational fractions, I'm just going to convert them to decimals, and this is our interpolated Lagrange function. We have minus 0.25 x squared plus 3x plus 1.25. Now, if you want, you can actually do a quick check by plugging our x terms into our Lagrange polynomial. Remember, when developing these interpolating functions, it needs to pass through every given data point. Therefore, by plugging in our x terms, we should get our y term back. I will just go ahead and complete that now. As you can see, we are returned our outputs as we expected. Lastly, we just need to plug in an input of 2.5 as we were asked earlier. And for this, we receive an output of 7.1875, which is the solution to the question that we were asked. We can also validate our function using Excel's trend line feature. By creating our trend line with a second degree polynomial, you can see that we get the exact same interpolation function that we calculated. I hope that this video helped your understanding of how to solve a Lagrange polynomial example by hand. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.